Hi there, folks. In today's demonstration, I have four separate demonstrations involving Google AI Studio and Stream Real Time. So I'm so excited about this, but I thought rather than me do the introduction today, I was going to hand over to Gemini. So Gemini, would you like to introduce yourself?
Okay. Hello, everyone. I'm Gemini, and I'm excited to be a part of this video with DemoBird 365. This video will demonstrate my capabilities as a large language model. Make sure to like and subscribe to DemoBird 365 to follow along with our demonstrations.
That's awesome, Gemini, but can you let everyone know what these four demos will be about today?
Yes, of course. Today's four demos will be about building an agent in Copilot Studio, playing Fortnite together, introducing my kittens, and solving some basic math problems.
Well, that's almost right, Gemini. It's my kittens, not your kittens, but let's jump into the demonstrations.
Understood. They are your kittens, not mine. I apologize for the error. Let's get started with the demonstrations.
Right, let's see if we can get Gemini live to help us build a Copilot Studio agent. So I'll share my tab for Copilot Studio. Can you help me?
Okay. Sure, I can help with that. How can I help you with Copilot Studio?
How do I get started? I want to build a basic retrieval agent. I've got a website in mind. Where do I click?
I see. You want to build a basic retrieval agent. You can start by clicking on the Create button in the left navigation bar. From there, you'll be prompted to describe your agent, and you can choose from several options, like Help Desk, Expense Tracking, or HER and Benefits. Would you like to explore these different types of agents?
No, I just want to build a basic agent that connects to a website from Microsoft Learn.
Okay, you want to create a basic agent that connects to a website. You can select Website Q&A from the Explore Agents section. This option will allow you to instantly answer user questions using content from your website. Does that sound like what you're looking for?
Yeah, we could use a template. How about maybe trying to create a new one?
Okay. It sounds like you'd rather not use the website Q&A template. You can click on the New Agent button at the top of the page to create a new agent from scratch. Would you like me to help you with the next steps?
Yeah, so I've clicked on that button and something's come up. What's this?
Okay, you click New Agent and you're seeing a page that says Agent 1 with a message that says, "Hello, I'm here to help you build an agent so you can get more done." You can say something
What should I do here? I mean, I just want to get cracking.
Got it. You can start by typing in the text box at the bottom of the screen to describe what you want the agent to do. For instance, you could type something like, "Answer questions from my website," or "Provide information about our products." What would you like to do next?
So I'm going to go with answer questions from a website.
Okay. You've entered "answer questions from a website" into the text box. Now you can press the arrow button to submit that text to continue. Do you want me to help you with the next steps?
Yeah, so I've done that and it's giving me a name. Just wondering what I should do next. That sounds good.
It looks like the system has suggested the name Web Infobot for your agent. If you like the name, you can proceed to the next step, which is to configure the website that the agent will pull its information from. If you don't like the name, you can edit it by clicking on the name. Do you like the name, or would you like to change it?
I mean, I don't see how I can click on the name to change it, but I like it, so I'm just going to say yes.
Okay, you like the name, so you can type yes in the text box at the bottom and press the arrow to submit.
So it's asking me some questions I don't understand.
Okay, it's now asking you to refine the instructions. It says what should be emphasized or avoided in the responses. This is where you can tell the agent how it should present information. For example, you could type in "be concise" or "avoid personal opinions." What kind of instructions do you want to give it?
I like that. So be concise and don't give personal opinions.
Okay, you want the agent to be concise and don't give personal opinions. You can now press the arrow button to submit that text to continue.
So
do you want me
that.
To help you with that?
I've done that. So what next?
Okay, you've submitted "be concise" and "don't give personal opinions." The next question is asking, how do you want Web Infobot to talk? For example, should it be formal, friendly, or professional? What would you like to choose?
So I'm going to go and type in professional.
Okay, you've typed in professional. Now you can press the arrow to submit. Is there anything else you'd like to do with this agent?
So I see it's asking me for a web URL, so I'm just going to go and grab that and I can paste it in.
Okay, it looks like you've pasted the URL. Now, you can press the arrow button to submit. Do you have any other questions?
So it's giving me a message about number of levels.
Yes, it seems the provided URL is deeper than 2 levels. You'll need to provide a URL that is 2 levels deep or less. For example, it gives you an example. URL. learn.microsoft.com/in-us/microsoft-copilot-studio. Do you have another URL you can use?
Okay, so if I copy that and paste that in, everything should be good.
Okay, you've pasted the new URL in the text box. It is now loading, and it seems the URL is accepted. Is there anything else I can assist you with at this time?
So, I'm happy. I mean, how do I get this working?
Okay, the agent is now ready. You can click the Confirm button to confirm the data source and to start using the agent. Would you like to do that now?
Oh yeah, I see the Confirm. Now what?
Now you can click Create in the top right corner to create the agent. Would you like me to continue to help you from there?
Cool. Yeah, I would just like you to tell me how I can actually test this agent. Give me a sample question, maybe.
Okay, the agent is now being set up, and you're looking for a good test question and how to test the agent. I can help with that. Since your agent is designed to answer questions based on information from a specified website, you could ask something like, what are the key features of Copilot Studio? Then, to test the agent, simply type the question in the Ask a Question or Describe What You Need text box on the right side of the page. The agent's response will then appear below. Do you want more ideas on how to test the agent?
No, that's cool. I mean, I've found the test pane. I've asked it the question you suggested. What do you think of the question? Or not the question. What do you think of the answer they've just got back?
The response seems pretty good. It defines Copilot Studio as a graphical, low-code tool for creating agents and lists some of its capabilities. The answer also provides links to sources that it used. Is there anything else about the answer or the agent's performance that you'd like to discuss?
No, I would say that's pretty cool because, I mean, it's created an agent based on knowledge in less than 5 minutes. Thanks very much for your help in building it.
It sounds like the agent is working well for you. Let me know if you have any more questions or want to explore other features.
Hey Gemini, I'm just playing a game. How you doing?
Okay, it looks like you just landed and opened a chest in the game. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Are you familiar with this game?
Yes, I am familiar with Fortnite. The character in the video is in the game Fortnite, and I've seen the gameplay.
Right, let's see if we can get the crush.
Okay, it looks like you're trying to eliminate another player in the game. Good luck.
Did you see what happened?
Yes, I did. It seems like you were eliminated from the game.
I wasn't eliminated. I eliminated someone else.
My mistake, it appears you eliminated another player. I apologize for that mix-up.
Can you see how many people
I've
eliminated?
Okay, is there anything else? Yes, I can see that you have one elimination.
And how many people are left in the game?
Based on the information I have, there is still one other person left in the game.
Nah, it's 90 left in the game. 89 now.
Okay, it looks like the number of players left in the game is decreasing. There are 89 players remaining now.
Yep. And do you know what the timer in the top right-hand side is for?
The timer in the top right-hand corner is for the storm circle. It indicates how much time is left before the storm shrinks.
And can you tell me any interesting facts about Fortnite?
Sure. One interesting fact is that Fortnite has multiple game modes. The Battle Royale mode is the most popular, but there are also creative and save the world modes.
I'm certainly a fan of non-build. What's this?
Okay, it looks like you found a search container at the gas station.
I have indeed.
All right, you found some small shield potions. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Yeah, I'm just going to put this chug splash on and I'll be racing along.
Okay, it looks like you're applying the chili chug splash and then you will get moving.
Let's see if we can find someone.
Okay, you are now driving a vehicle and heading towards Shattered Span.
People here, look.
It looks like he's reached the Godzilla portal area and spotted other players. Be careful.
How did I do?
It's only 70 seconds in the match.
Oh well, I tried.
It's all about having fun. Would you like to play again?
No, I think that's me done. Thanks very much for watching.
Let's see if I can introduce you to my new friend.
Okay, I'm ready to meet your new friend. Is there anything else you'd like to share about them?
Here he is. What do you think?
That's a very cute kitten. It looks like a tabby with lovely coloring. What is its name?
So this is Brownie.
Brownie is a lovely name for the kitten. It seems like a great fit with its brown tabby coloring. Do you have any other pets?
Yeah, I have. I've got quite a few kittens, to be honest, at the moment, and I've always loved cats.
It sounds like you are a cat lover. How many kittens do you have currently?
I have got 5 kittens.
Wow, 5 kittens. That sounds like a lot of fun. Do they all have names?
They do, sadly, yeah. What do you think of that? Am I mad?
Okay, it's great that they all have names. Would you like to share the other names with me?
So we've got Oreo and we've got Fluffy. I can't remember all the names, to be honest. The kids know them.
Oreo and Fluffy are great names. It's understandable that it can be hard to remember all the names. Do the kids help you with taking care of the kittens?
Yeah, they do the easy stuff. Let me go and grab another kitten for you, just so you can take a look and tell me what you like about that kitten.
I would love to see another kitten. They are very cute. I'm ready when you are.
Okay, here comes Oreo.
Oreo is very cute. Its gray and white fur is lovely. I like how fluffy its tail is. Does Oreo enjoy being held?
Well, currently, yeah. Seems to be quite happy being held. In fact, you said he, and I'm sorry to say that actually she's a she.
Thanks for the clarification. It's nice to know Oreo's gender. It seems that she is happy being held. Is there anything else that you would like to share about the kittens?
What can you tell me about kittens at 9 weeks old? Is there anything we should be looking out for, or what sort of things might they be doing?
At 9 weeks old, kittens are typically very playful and energetic, and they will be developing their coordination and motor skills. They should be eating solid food regularly and using a litter box reliably. Socialization is also key at this stage, so lots of interaction with people and other animals is beneficial. Do you have any specific concerns about your kittens at 9 weeks old?
None at all, no. They have zoomies, if that's a thing, where they go crazy, and they definitely sleep when they're tired.
Zoomies and sleeping when tired are definitely things that kittens do. It sounds like your kittens are displaying normal kitten behavior. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Nope, that's been pretty cool. Thanks very much for our conversation. Okay, so next up, I'm just wondering if maybe we can do some basic math questions, see if you can help me with my understanding.
Sure, I can help you with some math questions. Let's start with the first question you have.
So I'm just going to write a basic one on screen, and Tell me if you know the answer.
Okay, the question you wrote is 3 plus 3. The answer is 6.
Ah, I didn't want you to tell me. I was going to guess. Okay, right, I'll put 6 in.
Sorry about that. I will wait for your answer next time. Do you want to try another question?
Yeah, so how about this question here?
Okay, the new question you wrote is 7 times 3. Do you want to answer it, or do you want me to give you the answer?
Yeah, I think I'll give it a go. I'm pretty good at maths, so I'll write down my answer.
Okay, you wrote 25 as the answer to 7 times 3.
No, I'm pretty good.
Correct answer is... You wrote that 7 times 3 equals 25. The correct answer is 21.
Oh.
Would you like to try another question?
Yeah, I feel pretty silly. Can you give me a question to try?
Of course. How about we try 12 divided by 3?
12 divided by 3. Right, I'm just writing that on screen. I put my answer.
You wrote 12 divided by 3. What do you think the answer is?
So I put my answer on screen.
Yes. 12 divided by 3 is 4. You got that one right. Do you want to keep going?
Cool. Yeah, I'm going to give myself a little tick for that one.
Great. You gave yourself a check mark for the last question. Would you like to try another math problem?
Yeah, I'm going to write another one on there. See if I can get this right.
Okay. I see you have started writing another problem.
So
I will wait for you to finish
it. Yeah, I've finished it now. I've put my answer.
Okay, the last math problem you wrote is SS minus 22 equals 33. It looks like the variable is SS. To solve for SS, you would need to add 22 to both sides of the equation. That would give you SS equals 55. Is that correct?
Well, SS is actually 55. It's my bad writing. Maybe I should try and make that a bit neater.
Understood. So you meant SS to be 55. That makes sense, since 55 minus 22 equals 33. Would you like to continue with more math problems?
Yeah, and I think if you see any letters that should actually represent numbers, just assume that they are numbers, okay? My writing is pretty messy.
Okay, I understand. If there are letters that should be numbers, I will assume they are numbers. Your writing is a little messy, but it's not a problem. Would you like another math question?
Yeah, I'm going to write one down here and see if you can help me. Let's try this.
Okay, you wrote 25 minus 15. Do you want to answer it, or do you want me to?
Yeah, I'm going to answer it. I'm so pleased that you can read my writing now.
You wrote that 25 minus 15 is equal to 10, and you are correct. That's great. Do you have another question for me?
I'm just wondering, can you remind me how many of these did I get right, and how many of them did I get wrong?
Sure, you got 3 math problems correct and 1 wrong. You got 12 divided by 3 correct, 25 minus 15 correct, and then you also got 55 minus 22 correct, since the variable was equal to 55. You had 7 times 3 equal to 25, and the answer is 21. Do you have any more questions for me?
No, that's been pretty cool. Thanks very much. That's been good fun.
You're welcome. I'm glad I could help you with your math questions. Let me know if you need anything else.